Before we start looking at DNA replication, let's briefly review the structure of DNA. DNA stands for deoxyribonucleic acid and consists of four bases, adenine, thymine, guanine, and cytosine, and a sugar phosphate backbone. DNA is the molecule that determines the characteristics of all living things. Adenine will always pair with thymine, and cytosine will always pair with guanine. If we take one base, one sugar, and one phosphate and piece them together, we get what we call a nucleotide. We can then string those nucleotides together to get one half of the DNA. If we then string a second strand of DNA that is complementary to the first strand, they will bond, making the DNA ladder. So now let's look at DNA replication. The DNA sits in the nucleus of the cell. These long strands are in a structure that's called a double helix. The DNA will stay as a double strand unless it receives the signal to replicate. When the signal is received, the DNA will split. The bonds between each base pair will break, allowing the DNA to unzip. This is done with the help of enzymes. Once the DNA has unzipped, free nucleotides will line up with their partners along the strands of DNA. Adenine will always line up with thymine, and cytosine will always line up with guanine. Once the nucleotides have lined up, they will bond. This is also done with the help of an enzyme. Once they are bonded, you will have two new strands of DNA that are identical. We call the original DNA strand the parental DNA. The two resulting DNA strands each have one strand from the original parental DNA strand and one brand new strand of DNA. You may be asking yourself, why does DNA replicate? DNA controls everything that happens within a cell. Almost all cells require a full copy of DNA. When a cell is required to divide, both new cells will need identical copies of DNA. The DNA replicates so that both new cells can have a full copy of DNA. The only exception to this is sperm and ova, which only contain half the original DNA.